for breakfast today, I'm thinking of eating granola and yogurt. I always like to change up my breakfast, and I used to not like breakfast, but because of lockdown, now I have time to like enjoy my food in the morning. I've quickly become a lover of breakfast. Since it's fall, I decided to spice my it up with some cinnamon. This coffee. This isn't all for me, by the way. This is like a lot. This is a lot of coffee if I do drink it by myself. This is also for my family.
You know the thing with cashew milk yogurt is that there's literally like no taste because cashews are pretty plain. Like cashew milk is like a very neutral taste, whereas soy milk is like I am soy milk. And I'm gonna put some of my burn granola on top.
So this is my breakfast: yogurt with homemade granola. I also drink apple cider vinegar in the morning before I eat. My sister hates this thing. She smells the vinegar and she's like, oh my God, get it away from me. Bone apple teeth.
I mean, I was vegan at one point. I eat a mostly plant-based diet, but you know, sometimes you just gotta like listen to your body and acknowledge what your body is wanting and craving and nourish it with what it needs.
So I have this theory. Think about it this way. So let's say you purchase a car that you've been wanting. You have three options. One, you can either fuel it with very affordable gas. Two, average. Three is a premium price. So obviously if you pay the premium price and take care of your car and fuel it with the good gas, it's gonna last and your car engine's gonna be like good. Likewise, that's pretty much the concept I follow when I think about like the food that I consume for my body. So if my body is a car, I personally want it to be fueled with good fuel, you know, like the which is why I try to consume organic. Lunch is usually the biggest meal. Today I had this pasta that was actually made out of peas. No. Edamame. I guess they're still peas. So they had 24 grams of protein in it, which kept me really full. I found it at Whole Foods. I've tried a lot of gluten-free alternatives to pasta, and I honestly think this was one of the best pasta alternatives out there, and that is saying a lot because I am a foodie when it comes to all things natural whole foods, because I do love whole foods. Actually, like natural, like healthy, I guess, if you had to call it healthy foods. I've tried most of the things at Whole Foods and Trader Joe's and Japan and in Europe. I have this weird thing of going to grocery stores and just looking at the produce because it makes me happy, and my friends think it's a little strange, but they are also the best because they understand my freaking obsession with grocery stores.
How is this even possible? I have been attempting to put on this bracelet for the past 5 minutes. Every time I put on a bracelet, I have other people do it for me, or I just spend a good 5 minutes of my life trying to put a piece of jewelry on my wrist. There's like a bobby pin method where you can somehow do it. You know what? I give up. It was worth a shot though.
5 seconds later.
Wait, I'm trying out the bobby pin method now. Essentially, we have this bobby pin. Let's see if this works. If it does, Pinterest has been helpful. Is this a fail? Is this not gonna work? Please work. Please. It worked. It actually worked. I will definitely start doing this more often. I did not think this was gonna work, but here we are. Bracelet is on.
Lately, I've been going to the park to go work on assignments. There's something about the slight change in scenery that somehow tricks my mind into feeling more productive. But let's be real, my productivity levels haven't changed at all. But you know, at least I'm trying. I miss being able to see my friends and ask them questions about assignments, but I need this credit to graduate. I am back from the park, and the first thing that I did is change out of my jeans into shorts. I have a few classes today that start in a few hours, and I'm not looking forward to it. Don't get me wrong, I actually do enjoy my classes. It's just Zoom University is a little hard. It's awkward, in my opinion. So I came back from the park. I had carrots and hummus, and then the hummus I had is my favorite hummus brand. It's super great ingredients, just like all organic and non-GMO, and you know what's in it, and you can pronounce everything, which are my three criteria when I'm choosing out produce from the supermarket. I refilled this thing three times today. The 32-ounce one, so about a liter. I think you're supposed to have like 3 or 4 liters of water, so it's perfect. And then I carry this around with me everywhere because it reminds me to keep drinking water. My dinner was a bit of tofu and miso soup, so going back to my Japanese roots, but I love tofu. I basically always get firm tofu, and then I use sesame oil and a bit of soy sauce, and I fry it up in a pan. As for the miso soup, I just had a bunch of veggies that I found in my fridge and just put miso in it, you know, just the classic way. And after that, I had frozen grapes. I usually like green grapes, but this time around, I switched it up a bit. Look at me changing things up by getting, are they called red grapes? Purple grapes? Purple grapes versus red grapes. Oh, no, they're called black grapes. Okay, so purple grapes aren't a thing. I think it's either red grapes, green grapes, or black grapes. Red grapes actually do make sense because of red wine. Green grapes are literally just green. Black grapes don't look black, but I guess someone thought it looked black, so they called it black grapes. You learn something new every day, I guess. I love freezing grapes. It's like a small little popsicle, but you don't have to put in the work of making a popsicle, and you don't have like the plastic trash of if you eat a popsicle. A win-win for all of us. I was gonna go for a run, but I got a little lazy, so I'm gonna go for a walk. This is today's sunset. Not really a sunset because there's a lot of clouds. Usually you would be able to see Malibu and just the ocean in general, but not today. Not today, but it's still pretty, so it's okay. はい、ありがとうございます。失礼いたします。